Nate Diaz, the pound-for-pound king of the UFC, right here with Shaquille O'Neal. Shaq, of course, considered by many one of the greatest, if not the greatest, NBA player of all time. Nate Diaz, considered the pound-for-pound king, if not the greatest MMA fighter of all time, right here, right after his win this past weekend over Anthony Perez. Nate Diaz was the underdog. I was just at the RGBA, Robert Garcia Boxing Academy, today, and Pita told me his friend bet $90 and won $7,000. $7,000, that's how much people were confident that Nate Diaz was not going to win. They don't know anything about MMA, just like Roger Mayweather would say about boxing. They don't know shit about boxing. So Nate Diaz posted this, and he said, "Big ass Shaq, that's my comment, badass pick." And you could see here, shout out to Chris Diaz for liking that. Shaquille O'Neal right under, here's his comment. "I always got your back. You taught me that Sacramento slap." Because there's, I mean, Shaquille O'Neal, part of the owner of the Sacramento Kings. And Nate Diaz, of course, has the Stockton slap. And Nate Diaz responded to Shaquille O'Neal. I'll show you Nate's response in a second. Shaq is a huge, huge fan of Nate Diaz. I've been talking to him about MMA and the Diaz brothers going back years and years and years. Shaquille O'Neal has always been a huge MMA fan before it was popular, before it was mainstream, before it blew up. Sacramento slap. Chuck Zito says, "Two legends, Road to War, 100. Nate responded with an emoji of a slap and 100. OG Goonster, shout out to Goonster. Chris Diaz, Diaz Brothers underscore represent 209. Bam Bam Baklava, who has a lot of followers, says tremendous. But Shaq, I even talked to him before this fight last week, and he was excited for this. He told me that he loves the Diaz brothers. And in a video that I posted, you can see with Nick Diaz, Nate's brother, Nate told me that he's been hanging around with Shaq, and they went to a hookah lounge, and Shaq was DJing and invited him up to be in the VIP and all that. So there you have it. Stay tuned. Nate Diaz posting a picture on his IG. By the way, Nate is already at 3.2 million followers. And this is without anyone promoting him, without having the big UFC machine push him like some fighters do. So it's all organic, and the fans are real, and the fans do engage. So he has a very solid. That's why when they announced that he fought, that he's fighting, the arena was sold out. And that's why the numbers are great. And that's why Nate holds the record for the highest UFC pay-per-view. He is, like I said, the pound-for-pound king of the UFC. Now, you could say, "Oh, he doesn't have a belt." Just like in boxing, in the UFC, belts don't mean anything. Belts, okay, it's cool to have a belt. Nothing wrong. No disrespect to champions. But in boxing, at least, it's very watered down. You could be the best fighter in the world. Like Adrian Broner tells me, you don't need a belt to go to a grocery store and buy food. You can't buy food with belts. It's about getting paid and putting on the best fights and fighting the best fighters, not necessarily fighting for a belt. Because what happens is, and this is the reality, a fighter will win a belt and then might want to babysit it, may not want to give it up, may hold on to it. And then you get into people so obsessed with that strap. It's not about... Maybe the first time you win a championship, it's exciting. But once you've won that one belt, like Deontay Wilder told me, when he unifies all the belts, he's giving them up. Because the sanctioning fees for all the sanctioning bodies, that comes out to a tremendous amount of money. And when you make $20 million or $15 million, 3%. Times 4 or 5 adds up. So there you have it. Stay tuned for ESNEWS.com. I'm Isaac Piper.